Welcome to video three of this four-part video series, and today we are going to touch on some of the strength exercises and a little some more mobility exercises that are going to be really, really great to help improve your back care. So if you remember from yesterday's session and when I touched on how some tight muscles, particularly the hip flexors and of course the lower back muscles, and the underactive, more weaker muscles, i.e. the glutes and core muscles, all contribute to the pelvis tipping forward and putting that pressure on the lower back stroke lumbar spine. So today we're going to work on the weaknesses, so we're going to strengthen the weakened muscles. Now, with these exercises, some of them you might have seen before, but the trick is, and this is very, very important, is how you do them, okay? So we're gonna really, really strip it right back. We're gonna get right into the detail, because the muscles we're trying to work and target aren't used to being worked, and they're almost lazy. It's a term switched off, as it were. So you sometimes really struggle to actually feel them and connect with them in what's called that mind-muscle connection. So it's not a case of bashing out 20 reps of X exercise or Y exercise or anything like that. We're going to really strip it right back and really get the feel of it, because it's the how you do it is what's really key and what's really going to improve that pain problems you have. So first, what we're going to do is, it is an activation exercise, but it's also a mobility exercise. So they're called hip curls. So I want you to lie flat on your back, feet flat on the floor. And again, it might take a moment to get comfortable. Now, like most people, you have an arch of that lower back, okay? And with this exercise, I want you to think about, say, this is your pelvis, and I want you to think about tucking it back and pressing your lower spine into the floor and then rolling up into this bridge type position. Now, if you do it right, what you're going to feel is the glute muscles working and switching on, and you'll actually feel a really, really nice stretch on the lower back, because it's going to round and open up and ease off that pressure, okay? But what you don't want to do is just push up like that and arch the back, right? The pelvis will tip forward then, and you hyperextend here, right? You wanna push the ribs down and tuck the pelvis under to get all that work through those glutes. So we really wanna switch these fellas on. Now this is a real personal favorite of mine, especially before I squat and I deadlift, to really make sure that these fellas are really switched on, really activated, so that when I do go to my bigger exercises, that the glutes are firing and that my back isn't gonna take that work, okay? So very easily, very slowly, very controlled. Have your hands cross the lower part of your rib cage. Nice big deep breath in. And as you breathe out, start breathing out, pull your navel into your spine and push your lower back, flatten into the ground, and start gently rolling your hips up off the floor and keeping that rib cage down. Now it will lift up, but you don't want to let it arch, right? Keep it down. And hold. And now if you do this right, you're going to feel your glutes kicking in. If you can, reach out and feel them, right? They should be working. And then roll back down and again. Breathe in. Breathe out. Up again, just as high as you can. If you go too high, again, you'll feel the lower back, then you know you've lost it. You've got a bit too high, okay? Breathing up. Squeeze, connecting with the glutes. And then roll back down. Breathing out, tucking under, squeeze, roll back down. The best way to think about doing this exercise, if you imagine the spine like a string of beads, all right? It's coming up one bead at a time, and you're replacing it one bead at a time. If you really start imagining in your mind's eye how to almost segment the vertebrae, and we'll get much more movement all the way down and all the way back up. But like I said, we're also strengthening the muscles that need to be strengthened. So we're teaching the pelvis to come back into that neutral position and take the pressure off the lower back. Now, if you find that a little bit too easy, and some of you guys might. Some of you guys might really struggle with that. So if you want to take it up a notch, really simple, do a single leg version. Now the single leg version is the exact same thing. However, we'll always have differences from left and right. So this will really highlight the difference of which side is weaker than the other, okay? So exact same thing, I flat your back. This time, you're just gonna lift your knee right up over your hip. Nice big deep breath in, nice breathe out, tuck that pelvis under, and up, and squeeze again, all that work to my right glute, and roll back down. Bring up, squeeze again, keep my ribs down, tummy in tight, glute working, back down, again. To the other side, breathe in, breathe out. Now this, my left side is much weaker than my right side because this is the side of my injury on. So this is always a bit more challenging for me. So I always really need to concentrate that little bit more on feeling it. Ah, there we go, got it. Those are called spine curls. Sorry, I think I might have called them something different earlier. Or hip curls, spine curls, hip curls, same thing. Again, really, really nice one to start with. So again, brilliant strengthening exercise for the glutes. Nice little bit of mobility for the lower back. And it's a really good way to get you going. So, next one, I'm gonna bring some ab and deeper core exercise into play here. Now this is a full spinal stability exercise, spinal and pelvic stability exercise. It's a little bit more advanced, but I'll show you versions to make it easier. And you'll always know the general rule of thumb, if you're feeling it too much in your lower back, you're probably not doing it right. So you just need to take a step back because you don't want to repeat these habits, all right? It is a bit of a check to the ego to do these exercises properly, and I'm speaking from my own experience here because I went from a pro fighter to having to do Pilates with a bunch of middle-aged women. So it is a bit of an ego check, but please just focus on the how you're doing this exercise. The how is the key here, okay? So you might have seen an exercise called cat-cow, where you arch. Again, that'll be in yesterday's one. Again, really, really nice spinal opener. Now, same position, hands under the shoulders, knees directly under the hips. Now, we're going to, again, pull the tummy in, nice and tight. Again, find that position. You want to be rounded, you want to be arched, you want to be the midway point, wherever's comfy. Up onto your toes, all right, we're gonna hold. Nice and steady, right. Now from here, see, again, most of us, this is going to be pretty challenging. If you can do this without letting it arch or rounding or anything like that, perfect. Right. If you want to take it up a notch, now from here, without anything moving, you're going to lift one leg and extend it all the way back. Now I'm obviously a little bit too close to the wall. Downside's being tall. So we'll try that again. In here, again, nice and tight. Lift one leg and extend back. So again, I'm squeezing my left bum cheek and we come back in and I hold. Again, I pull up, draw my belly button in and I extend. Again, squeeze my bum. What I don't want to do is like wait, is arch my back like that. I don't care about how high my leg goes. I care about extending it out. It can just be above the floor, okay? Squeeze that bum back in again. Tummy's doubling in. Extend that leg. Squeeze. Back in. Again, from yesterday, some of yesterday's exercises, we've seen the rotations. From here, it's a really nice one. Just to double these up. And again, on the next video, we're going to do I'll do a full routine. We can see how you can start putting these exercises together in it must ultimately call a flow, which is traditionally a yoga term. Like I said, I've kind of mashed together yoga, Pilates, strength training, all sorts of CrossFit, strongman, powerlifting, bodybuilding. I've kind of taken the best bits of all these things and mashed them all together to bring you this course, basically, and this is what has worked. So, again, we're talking sets and reps and stuff. It's very, very dependent. For most people, if you can do the knees off the floor version, the more advanced version, and keep that work into the glutes, I would say anywhere between 8 to 10 in total each side for 3 sets. Again, I'll write this down underneath, so don't worry about the sets and reps. No, actually, I don't want to get too bogged down. Again, but feel free to play around, right? The recommendations I give are just that. I don't know your body. You know your body. I'm just here to tell you the things to look out for and the things to avoid. Okay? So, we'll go into that the next time. Right, now from here, we're going to flip around onto our back. Again, this one is a real personal favorite. I'm going to shuffle up again, long legs. So again, initially I want to support my pelvis and support my lower spine. So I'm going to use my hands into fists. Right? And I'm going to tuck the hips under, put my hands underneath, and sit on them just so that I can tip my head with pelvis backwards and there's no undue pressure on the lower spine. Legs go up. Now, as I press my lower back flat into the floor, I'll extend out. Now, if your back starts to arch, you know you lost it, right? What you're looking for is ribs down, lower back imprinted on the floor. You should feel that here. Extend out, back in. Now, if you can't go the whole way out, that's fine. Even if you go 3/4 of the way, back in. All you're wanting to do is challenge the stability. So, brace, extend, back in. Extend, back in. Again, this is an absolute favorite when it comes to warming up for squats. Because again, if you think about it, this is a squat lying on my back, right? My brace and core, or my abs and core are braced, and my legs are coming up and down. So if you flip me over this way, it's a squat, right? So you can see how these exercises will always serve you, they'll always have a place in your routine for the bigger exercises. Now I'm going to take this up a notch. Now this is a great exercise, however I don't use it as a warm-up for squats, and because we're now bringing some movement into the pelvis and spine, and I don't want to do that when I'm squatting, all right? So this is the caveat here. We separate it sometimes, other times we can push them together. So again, hands under. Lower, particularly lower spine braced, extend the legs out, and roll back down slowly, and away. So again, this is a lovely lower back opener, but I'm getting much more abdominals in here now as well. So the key here is to keep your heels close to your bum as you can. And so you want to go tight into a little ball and control as you lower down. Again, really, really lovely. If it's too much, if it's causing too much pain, or if you're too tight and you can't get that roll, then just stick with the extensions while keeping the back braced. Once your flexibility improves, you can start adding that one in. So again, use your discretion on that one. And of course, again, down below, I will put in the sets and reps and things like that. So again, you'll have a ballpark figure to aim for. So far, we've worked on the glutes, worked on rectus abs, transverse abs, all the deeper core ones. So now we're gonna use the sides, so the obliques. And you get a little bit of lats as well, because they have a great, really great role to play in stabilizing pelvis and spine. And a really good one, but one that I see done so wrong so often is a side plank. Again, so one foot on top of the other. No, first of all, think of your alignment, all right? If you're on a zigzaggy line, then you're off. You want to get yourself in a perfect position. Again, tuck your pelvis under, and lift up, but I want you to try and push your hips up as high as you can. So you want to really contract here, but I don't want your arch, think of, again, ribcage, down, hips tucked under, and then hips up. And that is absolutely solid in here. Again, of course, you might see some variations. You can take your hand off, your hand down. Now, you could obviously lift your leg up, but I wouldn't necessarily recommend that because for me, the reward is so little by extending the leg and there's very little benefit. Or sorry, the benefit is so low and the risk is that bit higher. I don't like it. I would much prefer to hold it a bit longer or possibly add a weight in with different arm movements. But like I said, when you do it right and you hit that sweet spot, you won't need to. So one leg in front of the other, hips in line, pelvis under, ribs down. Totally square again. Each time I breathe out, I'm pushing my hips up to the ceiling, up and away. Oh, that's going right through here. Again, if I feel it in my lower back, I know I've lost it, I've arched, right? Again, I'm keeping everything super tight through that middle. So the next one we're going to do, I will build us this into another exercise then after, will be what's called bird dog. Now, there's a lot of variations with this. You might have seen this one as well. It's quite a common one. Again, it's one of these ones you see it a lot, but you very rarely see it done right, if at all. So, leg on your back. And the variations I'm kind of referring to usually includes lots of bands and things like that. And you can get them. However, I wanted to keep this as simple as possible with no equipment, you know, something you could do at home, something that'll take you 10 minutes. And obviously, of course, be super effective. So, I'm gonna brace, press your ribcage down onto the floor. One leg up, other leg up, hands. So, if you can imagine my spine, or my plastic spine that I had in the first video, that's the only thing that's touching the floor right now. Obviously, my head as well. So, now because I'm tall, this is harder because of longer limbs. Now, a bit of coordination here. So, all I'm really focusing is again that lower back right into the floor. I'm going to extend my left leg and my right hand right back and back. Give myself a bit more room. Again, pressing down, tummy in tight. This is a really, really great one. Of course, there's a bit of coordination here, but the key benefit of bird dogs is the crisscross effect. So I'm going right leg, left hand, and vice versa. That is what's called, we're recruiting what's called your abdominal sling or oblique slings. So because you've opposite sides going the way, your body will naturally want to twist, but we're bracing and we're resisting against that. So it's absolutely firing up the core. It's a brilliant one. Fine. So that's it for today. Underneath, I'm going to lay out the sets, the reps, and recommend general guidelines on how to perform these exercises. But of course, like I said, and I will keep saying, this is your body. It is your responsibility to make sure that you're doing it right. I've given you the know-how, I've given you the how, the what's, the don't, the do's and the don'ts. Make sure you do it right. Keep an eye out for tomorrow as I post or send over this next video. I will put a full-blown routine together and you can put all together the mobility, the flexibility, and the strength exercises into one routine that's going to be absolutely awesome for you. Keep an eye out for that and talk to you then. Take care. Bye.